Play the smiley face lady.
That's the one that's unavailable.
Aww.
That's
literally the only one that's worth playing is the one that is not playable.
But Brad, these are like, there's a wide array of anime people here.
Okay, that guy doesn't even have eyeballs.
It's got cyber eyes. That's Bato.
Okay, that's probably better than regular eyes.
Yeah, probably.
Can you zoom in?
I can get info.
Ooh, look at the, wow. Nobody's getting away from my arm launcher. He's got cyber voice too.
Yeah, he's got cyber voice because he's got an arm launcher. We can go in here and we can view more.
Whoa.
Yeah, also.
What? There's anime in this game.
There's a little bit of anime in this game, which is weird because it's a Ghost in the Shell game. Ghost in the Shell, standalone complex, first assault online.
That's a lot of brands.
I think is the actual name. God, we're gonna have to shift tab this thing because the name of this thing is crazy.
What is standalone complex? Is that like a
Well, Brad, I'm glad you asked.
I don't.
Standalone Complex was a 2-season TV show.
Okay.
That was set in the Ghost in the Shell universe.
I see.
Kind of a follow-up from Ghost in the Shell. I don't know that it's necessarily.
Which was a film.
Which was a film.
Okay.
Released in the mid 90s.
I saw it.
An animated film.
I watched it at one point, and I have no memory. Okay, so Ghost in the Shell did start as just a movie, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
So. Upon the release of this thing and me playing it, I was curious.
Okay.
I had to know, and the break for the holidays was long.
Uh-huh.
So I took it upon myself to watch Ghost in the Shell.
The movie. Okay. Where can you see that? Because I have a weird hankering to go back and watch it again.
Blu-rays and DVDs,
okay,
it might be on a streaming service or two. I don't actually know about the streaming services. Got a hold of a physical copy of it and watched it.
All right.
And it's not great.
Okay.
But it's like sets up a world. I feel like I bet it's something that if you watched it then, it probably blew your damn mind.
People were very into Ghost in the Shell back when it came out.
Watching it now, it's like a barely 90-minute production that has time for like two way too long montages where very little happens. And basically like very little happens in that thing.
But people feel a lot during those montages, I'm sure.
Yes, yeah, it's got style.
Yes. I remember, I feel like I remember there being like some prominent CG in that movie and it was like an early example of
there
like,
was.
Here's CG in an animated movie.
So they re-released it as Ghost in the Shell 2.0 and redid some of the CG. To kind of bring it up to a more modern standard here.
Okay.
But Standalone Complex is a lot of the same characters in a similar universe, or the same universe. I can't tell you if it's like, if they're canonically connected or if this is like a retelling or whatever, because I did not watch enough Standalone Complex to tell you one way or the other.
Is Kusanagi there?
Yes.
Okay. The Major?
Yes.
Major Naga way back.
Yeah, I bet.
I think she's a Major. I don't know. What is this? Is this a shooter?
This is a first-person shooter.
Okay.
Like so you know, they built this universe and it's all about style and all this other stuff. And then like it came time to make a video game, and you look at it and go like, man, there's a ton of like great material here that you could use to make a video game. And then we'll dive.
I don't know. Call of Duty's big.
And you've got a little anime here in the corner here while it was searching for a lobby, which is nice.
Just in case
a little bonus anime for you.
Just in case you can't live your life without seeing some anime every 90 seconds.
Well, I think the thing is like there's so little anime in the actual game. You almost get the impression that they just went like, oh man, we should probably put just something in the corner. This is in early access, so you know.
Really?
It is.
Oh, I did not know that.
So you do have to. It's going to be a free to play game, but you have to pay your way in right now by buying like they have like four different packages of credits and unlockable characters and stuff like that.
That's a weird way to go.
Yeah, it's like a closed beta.
I guess you're just kind of trying to filter to the people that really want to be there.
Yeah,
or
something like that.
While active development is still going on.
Right. Instead of just like opening the floodgates and getting a zillion people, like it gives them a more manageable. I don't know. It's a shooter. You have some abilities, you shoot stuff. Basically.
Abilities of a cybernetic nature.
Sure, yeah. Bato's got his arm launcher. His arm fires rockets.
Okay.
My lady here can use the stealth camouflage.
All right, that sounds useful.
Like the Predator.
Yeah, that guy would be a cool guy to have in a first person
shooter. I know, yeah.
What if there was a Predator anime? Would that work? Probably. I can see that working. I mean, I could totally see that working.
Yeah, why not?
This takes a long time to get into a match.
It doesn't always take that long, but here we are. So this is the team deathmatch mode. There are a couple more modes.
It's the dubbing site. This is where they do the dubs.
Yeah.
You are here to wipe out all anime dubbing. Yeah. Subtitles only from now
exactly.
on, motherfucker.
Subs only. Fuck this shit. So I can aim down sights. And I've got my team. And you don't last a long time.
That was some pretty good ragdoll, I have to say. Yeah. Like the way you did that little kind of flip over your own back.
And like America's Army, the bad guys always look like robots.
Oh, okay.
Or look like a set faction, even though they are playing as the same characters as you are.
I guess that's how they get around letting you play named story characters. Right.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. So we're just, you know, we're Section 9.
But wait,
doing
does that
Section 9 stuff killing robots?
But since the different player characters have specific abilities, does that lead to? Wouldn't that lead to cases where you are up against a person and you don't know what they can do?
Yeah, pretty much.
Because you can't tell.
But the abilities are not a huge factor.
Oh, okay. So it's not straight up. It's not like Team Fortress, like super differentiated.
Yeah, no, it doesn't. No, it's not that differentiated. Like the weapons and stuff you can choose from.
That guy got his head shot off.
Are the same. Yeah, it gets a little gory in spots, which is
kind of
nice.
We have like a robot
nice.
Head.
Yeah,
so
I mean, it's robots. Robot,
Australia
is cool with that. It's robots. Yeah.
So primarily a shooter then.
Yeah.
Not like an ability based, like class based thing.
No, you see down in the left corner there, I am charging up my ability. You can use it. I can pop it off right now, and it would be a tier one version of my skill. And it will auto-charge back up to the tier one level. But if I wait and do well enough to charge it up to tier two, then I get a more effective version of the skill. And also, you can skill sync some of your skills. Which lets other players get the tier one version of your skill.
Mm.
So I get better camo at tier two, and also other players on my team can activate tier one stealth camo when I pop mine off.
Okay.
And there are other abilities like speed boosts and seeker drones and some other stuff like that. Some can be shared, some can't. And that's kind of it. There are some other modes where there's like, you know, a bit of, you know, capture a point and that sort of stuff. Threw that grenade, I got an assist. All right, well, great.
It's a shooter. Is it? Is it good? Does it play well? Is it fun?
It's acceptable.
Is it fine?
There's not a lot to it. The weapons don't seem great. And it's in early access. So it's kind of, oh geez.
Whew.
So it's kind of hard to.
What? Oh, well, that guy had a robot.
Yeah. So the crazier part is that like, if you think about what Ghost in the Shell is,
which I do on a frequent basis.
Yeah, and then see it more or less. There's that drone is in there, so let's try and. I don't know that that did anything. Maybe it did some damage to the drone. Let's run over here and jump over here. Okay,
nice
so
kill.
I'm going to pop my tier 2 skill here, and those lines mean that person can do a skill sync, and I'm getting points because they're turning on their tier 2.
Are those just match points, or is that like going toward your overall like account level or something?
Both. You end up kind of leveling up and stuff like that.
Very Call of Duty-esque, all of this, I take it.
Yeah, you know, plus 100. Right there in the middle of your screen.
You know what you're getting into here. How's the melee?
It is an item. So it's selectable. It's not an offhand grenade, not an offhand melee.
They really took a cue from Black Ops 3, huh? Just everybody's everybody's throwing their hands up and going like, fuck it, melee's whatever we want. Enemy down. No standards anymore.
Exactly. Well, you know, by doing that, it lets them have different items that you could then purchase for real money.
Okay.
Which they don't have any additional melee items yet, but that's.
Well, I was going to ask what the business model was, or like what it is that they're selling exactly.
Right now you're buying credits for a store. Okay, so I'm going to skill sync, and someone else popped a tier two.
Or maybe you can just show me the store. After
yeah,
this.
I will.
It'd be easier. Nice kill.
All right. So I got three loadouts here. I got an SMG, which is also a gun. There's some shotguns. I've got a pistol that I can switch to. Oh, but there's stuff that, like, you know, if you... I'm not, like, weird about the lore of Ghost in the Shell, obviously. But there's some stuff in here that, like... Like, there's one guy who is obsessed with an old revolver.
Mm.
That's, like, his sole character trait.
Does he have a mustache?
No.
Oh, it seems like a guy like that would have a mustache.
Yeah, but okay. He's got a mullet.
Mm, okay.
A cyber mullet.
Wait, what?
No, he's a guy who is only lightly modified compared to a lot of the other members of the squad. And he likes this old-ass revolver. And in Ghost in the Shell, the film, on two separate occasions, they give him shit about liking this old gun. In the info screen for that character, it talks about how much he loves that gun.
Okay, but...
That gun is not in the game.
That's what I was going to ask.
Yeah.
Figured that's where that was going.
There is a revolver, but not the one. It's just a 44 Magnum. It's not the Mateba.
I was going to ask if his gun had a name.
Yeah.
Sally.
Nanogel
shut down. All right, so I'm maxed out on my skills, so I'll pop it and... Hey, hi.
Wow.
That bad things happened to my cyber lady.
Not much left of you there. How cyber is she? Is she like...
She is mostly... She is almost completely
mostly
cyber.
Robot?
Yeah, she is... Well, what is it?
I don't remember.
I just watched this thing. She has some brain cells that are organic.
Wait, really?
She's literally
an entirely robot body?
Yes.
Jeez. That's pretty intense.
So we'll get through this match and then go back into the menus and maybe I'll unlock another character and we can see how that goes. Until then, I'll just run up to people and shoot at them. Okay. So it's unlike a Call of Duty, this is, I have hit points and armor points in the corner there. This is not a duck behind something and everything's gonna be okay type of game.
Oh my God.
That's bad.
That thing is small.
We got wrecked.
Scroob.
Scroob indeed.
Like, yeah. Okay, sure.
Hail Scroob.
Loser. Jeez, man. They're really just rubbing your face in it.
Yeah, it's kind of messed up. Look at this lady. She's bummed out.
It says loser in two different places there.
Like Payday, I can pick some. So these are some limited use items that you'll get and you can slot into things. I've also made progress on unlocking more parts of my cyber brain and some sights and stuff. We will quit out of this lobby and go back into the armory, which is stuff that we have. So you see, here's like, you know, stuff that we're unlocking by playing the game. There are weapons that you can kind of dictate like what you're putting points towards. Like, hey, I want to unlock this next gun. So, you know, put the unlocking points toward this and this and this. But you see, like the Megatech knife, there's nothing else here that I have in my...
That's a pretty cool looking knife.
Yeah, you know, these are the kind of guns that would be in your armory as you unlock them, and these are things you would unlock without, you know, spending money. I've got a grenade as well. If we go to the market here, they are selling guns for GPs here.
Which are the credits you can buy with real money.
Yes, okay. This is the real money currency here that you get for buying stuff. So that's stuff like, you know, hey, primary weapons, secondary weapons, this Magnum I was talking about, which is not the... We'll preview the Magnum. Got a good look at it?
Yeah.
You know what that gun looks like?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Let's go back to operatives. We'll go to Mullet Man here. And we'll...
That's
the gun. His gun.
Oh, wow.
Not the same gun.
No, definitely not.
Not the same gun.
I don't think... The one you could buy didn't have that nice little inlaid stock there. Or grip,
hey,
I should say.
Hey, you know what? The game's in early access.
Yeah, there's time.
Whatever.
So are these guns completely different from the guns you unlock?
Yes, they are. And
you can only get these with real money?
Yeah, some of these guns are only available with real money, but you know, they don't seem that they're necessarily out of balance.
Mm.
Is either this AK has, you know, lower stability fire rate, but more damage and stuff like that. And you know, I haven't crunched all the numbers or played enough to tell you one way or the other if there's a gun that's way out of balance, but
might be more of a case of just, hey, if you want this type of gun now, you can just pay for it now?
Sure, yeah.
Or you'll get a similar one after you unlock it?
Yeah, maybe something along those lines. Nothing up in the store for melee.
I can get scrambler grenades or smoke bombs if I wanted to go down that route. They have attachments for the weapons, and these have pluses and minuses, you know, but in frequently they're, it's a movement penalty. Mm. So, you know, you'll have, so this is +2 to accuracy, but this laser sight is so heavy that our movement speed is going to go down by 1, which is perhaps ridiculous given how big a laser sight actually is on a gun. Also, she's a robot. You know, weapon skins, presumably they'll sell those, some outfits, they'll sell those.
This there's no outfits?
This is an alternate outfit that she's wearing for one of the packs that they're selling on the store. It comes with the military version of the outfit for her. And then operative licenses, which allow you to unlock additional characters.
I see. What is a free-to-play game without hats?
Yeah, exactly.
Boring. I mean, you know. That's what.
Yeah.
What was the in that view you were at in a minute ago? The guy standing behind her, was that the like alternate the other team version?
Yeah, that's what the enemy will see.
Okay, so can you customize that as well?
Presumably? No, but I would imagine that maybe eventually you would be able to. I can't actually.
It'd be nice, like even if they're not going to see who you actually are, it'd be nice if you could at least control what they do see.
Right, I agree. That would be a nice thing. So I'm going to presume that that's their eventual goal, because otherwise, why would they have this here at all?
Right.
Or maybe each one of these characters has a unique silhouette as these characters, so you can tell which one is the stealth camo lady, and so on. Also, there's one more aspect of character creation here. If we go back into the armory, what is it? Items? No. No, that's at the operative level here. We go in here, click on her here, info here.
Cyberbrain firewalls and prepare to engage.
We can turn her into it. Yeah. Ah, that's right.
Wasn't ready for that.
So there are sockets here that we can socket in these limited use things here. So agile reload lets you reload while sprinting. Durability 20. So these are items that degrade, you know? So you can slot them in.
And then are they just gone when they break? Or?
Yes.
Huh.
So we mount that. It's mounted. 20, maybe that's 20 matches. Maybe that's 20 minutes. I don't know.
You can't.
It's 20. Huh. Actually, it's 5 matches. Anyway.
Presumably, you will keep getting those things, though.
So. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Those drop at the end of matches, basically.
Okay, so you'll probably build up a stock then.
Yeah, so we've got our costume, you know, selection stuff here. And then back to the profile, you can, you know, watch a little bit of anime.
Yeah, but we already saw this one.
Little slice.
Not a ton. This is from the show again? Is that right?
That's probably from Standalone Complex, the show. Which then later got repackaged into, like, what is it, like 3 movies or something like that?
Sure.
Because why wouldn't
you? Why not?
You know, they got your beard guy here. Here he is, hooked up to some kind of machine. Oh, all right, this is the guy in the original Ghost in the Shell. There's one scene with him where he's hacking stuff inside some kind of pod or something.
Okay.
I think that's the only role he plays in that. Mm. But you can shoot with him if you want to, and he can deploy a cyber sentry.
Got pretty good hair.
So seeker drone, heat sensor, which I guess would let you see people through walls.
He's got a cyber eye patch.
Yeah.
I'll take him out before you even see him.
Okay. Let's look at his anime real fast. Why not?
I want to see your anime.
Detail movie.
He's a cold-hearted warrior with an unbreakable poker face.
The least cyberized members. Huh. Okay.
All right. Ah, bullets.
Is there still much of a Ghost in the Shell fandom? Like, are they making more of it?
The Standalone Complex stuff has proven to be quite popular, though. Okay. That is even 10 years old or something.
I was
going to
say, I feel like I heard that name ages ago even.
Yeah, there was a PSP game based on Standalone Complex.
Right.
If that tells you anything. Nanogel armor, which didn't, we killed a couple of guys that had that, so that didn't seem that great. Hyper sprint, which you can give to other players. But this guy looks like he sucks. Look at him.
You're welcome to challenge me.
Yeah, I think you're right. All right. Smoking and drinking.
He's rumored to have been a member of the Japanese mafia before joining Section 9.
Wait, where's the back tattoo?
Oh, he's taking off his shirt. Maybe he's... Oh, no. He's got a cyber pinky that he put back on to replace the one. Actually, we should...
That's where all his mods are, in the
five
pinky.
Fingers, five. Oh, what?
Yeah.
No, that's... Okay, no, he's got all his... Okay. He's got all his fingers. All right.
Who is the mystery lady?
I think that's just her body model with a fake face to imply that someone else is coming soon. They actually posted an update recently saying that another character was coming soon that I imagine would go in that slot. I don't even think the character they're previewing is female, but
There you go. I don't know, man. I like this dude's mullet.
Yeah, it's
so
all right.
So we're gonna unlock him. And then select him. And then, same deal, he's got separate sockets. So that item I socketed on her is now
in use.
On her.
Yeah.
So I can't use it. Reduce scrambler stun by 20. That's not a problem I've ever had to worry about. So I'm gonna just not do that one. My account level is still level 2. Let's see here. Is that the same gun? That looks like the same looking character here on the enemy view.
Yes.
So maybe that's not different just yet. I don't know. Let's go into a match. So we got Team Deathmatch, which is what we played. Terminal Conquest.
Here's the anime clip that describes this mode.
Yeah, right? This one has some of those Tachikoma tanks.
Those things?
Which, yeah, those are those things.
Spider tank looking thing.
Yeah, the little tiny spider tanks that talk like kids or something. And then there's this demolition mode, which this is this is round based, I believe. Not no respawn in there. Why don't we try Terminal Conquest?
Dive.
Yeah.
So what brought all this on?
Why did they make this game?
No,
I don't know.
I mean, for you, like. Did you play this first and then seek out the movie?
I did play this first.
Okay.
I was like, oh man, a free-to-play first-person shooter based on Ghost in the Shell. Ghost in the Shell is something that seems stylish and potentially interesting, and something that might make for a weird first-person shooter with a ton of acrobatic anime craziness.
Right.
That's limited to if you run up against a low object while holding forward, you will vault over.
Yeah, I saw that.
That is the one. Yeah, you saw that prompt.
The mantle prompt.
Yeah. Well, maybe we don't get to play this mode because no one is playing it.
Ugh.
Well, take my word for it. It's a point control mode.
This seems pretty straightforward.
Like ultra straightforward in a way that you're like, why did you need the license for
right.
this?
That's,
like,
yeah.
What's going on?
Yes.
Why?
Yes.
What's going on? No, really though, what's going on?
I don't say this often or maybe ever, but this could use more anime.
Yes, I absolutely agree with you. This
For
needs.
Once, I would like to see more anime in this.
Yes, this needs probably 10 to 15 times as much anime as is in it now.
Yes.
In order to just to make sense.
Just saturate just submerge the thing in an anime bath.
And
for at least two weeks.
The reading I did on some of the storylines in Standalone Complex, it actually sounds kind of interesting.
Yeah.
So I talked to Austin about it as well.
Oh, he's a fan, right?
And you know, he described the show as kind of a cyberpunk procedural.
Huh.
As you know, they're just a secret police force.
Okay.
And they're out there doing shit.
Man, that sounds all right.
And there's some overarching storylines that go through a whole season that they check in on here and there, but also just like some episodes that are just about other shit.
Oh man, like
and
just
I actually kind of want to watch it.
Just the idea of like just being down at the precinct in a cyberpunk dystopia.
Yeah.
Like just cops doing cop shit.
Yeah.
Police work.
But they're secret cops, so that means they get to fuck shit up a lot as well.
Right.
When I was playing this a couple of weeks ago, zero problems ever getting into a match.
How old is this?
It's about a month.
Okay.
Maybe two.
I wonder if it's just falling off.
I wonder.
Which would be bad because it's not actually out yet.
Yeah, right?
But it's not free to play yet.
It is not. So. But I want to say the lowest tier to entry is maybe like $5 or $10. It's not like, you know, I think the most expensive credit pack is like 30. So it is not like it's a ton of money either way. I just don't want to go back to the dubbing site. I want to see one of these other maps.
Yeah, that would be nice.
I've played a lot of matches at the dubbing site.
It was a really drab looking map.
Yeah.
Get a little more anime in there.
Yeah, like, a lot more anime.
Make it look snazzy.
Put some anime up in this thing. And, you know, let's just give them the benefit of the doubt. Like I said, it's early access. But at the same time, like, this is... Oh, see, my silent camo... These are some of the things that I slotted
sockets.
Into my upgrade sockets. Yeah. And I accept.
Move in ready status.
Oh, okay. What?
I don't think you're trying to move, but okay. We need feedback.
What is even happening?
I have no idea.
Yeah. They need to join the forums. You know, there's a lot of just, if this was just some anime in a window, maybe that would be cool. Is there like a button I can hit over here for more anime? No?
Well.
Let's try the worst trick in the world of quitting and trying to rejoin. Let's just do random. Maybe that'll be the fastest way to get into something. See, look at that anime happening.
Yeah.
Bye, anime.
Well,
All right, let's go to American Empire East.
American Empire. A little on the nose there, guys, but okay.
That is from the source material.
I figured. But, you know.
Boom, players. Like, John Cena's in this match.
Cyberpunk fiction becoming reality all around us, right?
Sure.
So.
Just as you had hoped, but actually not quite as how you had hoped.
Yeah.
We must secure those terminals before leaving.
There, that's your anime acrobatics right there, was me vaulting over that thing.
Just your standard mantle.
Yeah. You know, no double jump, no wall run. No.
This won't be an easy fight.
Okay, so because we did not retake that terminal, there's now an enemy tank out on the field doing stuff.
Did it refer
hey, that
to
character
it?
Looks different.
Hmm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's right. It's map-based. It's map-based. The enemies look a bit different based on the map.
Okay. Do they refer to that as an enemy think tank?
Yes.
That's a pretty good name. I'm guessing that's a robot.
Yeah.
An autonomous tank.
I believe you're right.
That's a pretty good name for
so
a robot
tank. So this
capture
system rebooting, we can't actually take it yet, but we're just about... Okay, that's bad.
He shot his arm off. It's cool. So wait, can you get health back?
No.
No at all.
No. All right, we're taking the terminal. We are also slightly invisible. Oh, wait, I gotta be closer. My skill's ready. Let's put out the seeker drone and let it seek. There's two of them because I waited for, oh God. Okay, the seeker got somebody. That's good.
That seems pretty good.
This is going okay. I've almost got this terminal captured. With John Cena. Me and Cena are taking it. Cena never loses. We got this.
So I hear. People like John Cena.
I mean.
Is he actually a popular, I was about to call him a character, but I guess.
He's an incredibly popular character.
I guess his character even like that, that almost feels like a disrespectful way to refer to a wrestler.
I mean, they are playing a role.
I mean, I know that, but like.
Superstars is the preferred term.
Okay, fine. There's enough of themselves in there that. Like, just saying they're a character feels reductive.
Sure.
But I cannot ever gauge the temperature of how people feel about John Cena, actually.
So, he is very dedicated to his craft.
Okay.
But has also been, he has been the hero for years.
Uh-huh.
And that has led to a case where the people that are longtime fans of wrestling, the older crowd, is a little tired of seeing John Cena never lose, or seeing him only lose temporarily so that he can just win again.
Right.
But the reason he is in that role is because kids love John Cena.
Okay. Little kids, you mean?
Yeah. Like the children that are the true target of their product love that guy. He is a superhero.
I mean, he is like
Make-A-Wish Foundation's like number one wish granter of all time or something.
Really?
Like he is like
more than like actual Batman. Or
yes,
something.
Like to the people that are fans of that stuff, he is a Batman-like figure.
Jeez.
Sure, why not? Except less dark.
Just full on like square jawed all American.
Absolutely. Yes. He literally salutes as he walks to the ring.
Okay.
Ever since he was in the movie The Marine, gave up the hip hop act and started saluting on the way to the ring and just became the goodest of good guys.
Got
which
it.
Is also something that people are eventually kind of rebel against.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's one of those things where, you know, through little fault of his own, he has become less popular with certain segments of the audience.
That makes sense. I feel like I have a decent handle on John Cena now.
Yeah. I met the man over a decade ago now.
Jeez.
And found him to be a super nice guy.
Wow, that's cool. That's always nice to hear.
And he gets a bit of a bum rap, but you know, it's like blame that gets assigned to him should be blamed to the people writing the show.
Yeah, right.
And increasingly, especially now that he is out with an injury, he recently underwent surgery. Oh, God.
Wow.
Sort of like that. That's sort of how it went.
Man, that's pretty tough to come back from.
No, but he'll come back. He's John Cena.
Yeah, that's true. He never loses.
They are being forced to, or in some way, they are reaping what they have sowed. By putting him on top for so long at the expense of some of the other talented people out there on their roster, they have made it hard for the crowd to accept some of the people that they would like to put in the spotlight now.
Well, who else deserves the spotlight? Like, who's up and coming? And like, I feel like all I hear about wrestling these days is that everybody sucks and nobody's actually good.
There are a ton of people who are actually very good. It's the, I would lay a lot of the blame. The reason I stopped watching it, I would lay a lot of that at the writing. Mm. The writing of the storylines and the execution on that stuff has been profoundly poor. But in terms of deserve is a weird concept because, like, you know, it's a show that's being written. You know?
Well, who's got it is what I mean.
Who's
like,
got it?
Like, who has shown that they can handle, like, the top spot?
Very few people because very few people get the opportunity to have the top spot for any real length of time. Right now, this guy, Roman Reigns, who is the champion and is being kind of positioned as the top good guy.
Right.
And they are trying to turn him into an anti-authority figure.
Hero of the people.
Hero of the people.
Successor to The Rock.
Yeah, but it's the people who turned on him because the people, it's a weird thing where the people writing the show or the people calling the shots are also the on-camera evil authority figures.
Mm.
So it's like, on multiple levels, it's like, this is crazy because, like, they're the people saying Roman Reigns is going to be the top guy behind the scenes. They're also the guys that Roman Reigns is fighting against on the show.
So it all rings a little hollow.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I swear I remember people being super disappointed when Roman Reigns was, like, kind of anointed as, like, the guy who was going to win WrestleMania or something.
Yeah,
like that.
That was a problem because of the way they did it. And I think he's actually, I think he's quite good at what he does.
He deserves better.
And he's gotten a lot better.
Ah.
His ability to talk convincingly on the microphone was his major weakness. And I think he's come a long way there. He's maybe not quite there yet, but. But a lot of that has to do with, you know, again, the lines he's given.
Yeah.
And it's hard to know where the line is on that, how much of that is the performer and how much of that is the material. It was one of those things where he was incredibly well-liked, but because of the way they were positioning him, because of the way that they, like, people in the crowd felt that, like, he was being shoved down their throats as, like, you will accept him as the new good guy. Cool. A little kill animation there.
But that says all that needs to be said in terms of, like, why were people rejecting him?
Yeah. And they spent the last year finding ways to try to credibly build him up, and they've done better with it. But it's, you know, it's in some people's eyes, it will never be enough now.
Well,
especially because those people all have their own favorites that, you know, a lot of them are out injured right now. Guys like Daniel Bryan, like guys like Cesaro. And so with the number of injuries they've had, it sounds like they're on the verge of bringing in a lot of talent from a Japanese promotion.
Really?
That sounds like that those deals are in the process of being done ahead of the Royal Rumble, which is a match where they like to have a lot of surprises because it's 30 men in the ring. And you never know who those guys are going to be. It could be like people are coming from all over the world to fight for this prize. And so they like to bring people back at the Royal Rumble as a surprise thing, and even bring people in some cases as a surprise. So, it sounds like those surprises have been ruined because no one can keep their mouth shut.
Yes.
About the
good job, internet.
Yeah. But like, that's a very hand wringy thing right now for people that are fans of those Japanese wrestlers. And I mean, wrestling in that Japanese promotion, one of them, is from Georgia.
I was going to ask if any of these wrestlers were actually Japanese or if they were...
Yes.
Oh, they're getting actual... Okay.
Yes.
They're not just Americans who went over to that league.
Yeah, there's this guy, Shinsuke Nakamura, who is awesome.
Like, has there ever been that kind of crossover before? Because, like, you heard for the last, like, 20 years how awesome Japanese wrestling is, but it didn't seem like any of... Well, maybe some of them... came over and I just didn't know about it.
The problem is like, you know, it speaks to the depth of the writing. In a lot of cases, when they bring in people who don't speak English as clear as possible, that limits their potential in the eyes of the people calling the shots. Right. A Vince McMahon might not believe that a guy like Cesaro, who speaks with an accent, or you know, this Nakamura guy. Like, a lot of times you have foreigners come in and they're just like, they're given the baseline 80s character of, right. Like you're an evil Russian.
Right, they're like turned into an ethnic stereotype,
exactly.
Basically.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's like...
Wrestling, not known for subtlety.
No, it's writing. No, not at all. I mean, it's a stage play. It's not about subtlety. It's about saying your line three times as loud as possible in a row so that everyone sitting around the ring is sure to hear it. Because you don't know where the camera is at any... Or you don't know which camera is on at any given time, so... So that you watch them say their lines multiple times, like off mic. I mean, like when they're like yelling at each other.
That sounds like a real carny trick.
Yes, absolutely.
So like
this is not the active terminal. No wonder there's no action here. I'm it's down here. This guy Nakamura is fucking amazing. He's like a Japanese. He's charismatic, like a Freddie Mercury or a Michael Jackson.
Whoa.
Like that kind of charisma.
Huh.
It just oozes it. Just like, I don't know how, but I don't know how that fits in with the way WWE writes its shows.
Right.
And so there's a lot of hand-wringing, I think, from people who are fans of some of these guys already that just know that they will just come in and get ruined by the whatever storyline they're forced into. There's another guy, AJ Styles, who wrestled for TNA.
Yeah, I've heard that name.
For a very long time, and he was kind of their most recognizable homegrown talent, and they eventually misused him to the point where he went to Japan and became maybe the best wrestler in the world.
Jeez. Although I never know what you mean by that, because there's showmanship and there's like actual technical.
Like just in terms of versatility and just technical prowess. He also injured some people. His move is one. His big move is one that if you don't take it the right way, you will mess up your neck real bad.
That seems like something that would, like, if you hurt too many people, you might not come back from that. I don't know. Is that not frowned upon?
Well, so it's one of those things where the mistake is not necessarily his.
No.
Because it's all about how the move is taken, right? I mean, it's, you know, if you tuck your head, which is apparently the thing that you are trained to do with a lot of moves, that means with the specifics of this move, the top of your head gets driven directly into the mat.
Nice! That sounds great.
Which has injured a couple people in a short period of time. You know, a string of bad luck, call it. It's a dangerous thing that they're doing.
I guess nobody should pretend that it's going to be safe by default.
Yeah.
Even if it's scripted, that doesn't mean that it's not dangerous.
And I trust that they take whatever precautions they can to keep each other safe in the ring. That's the whole point of that thing. If you can't trust, it's why all the handshakes are so light.
Cyber Sentry ready for action.
And so he got real good. He got real, real good when he got out of the U.S. But he's also not, like, hugely tall. He's not a monster.
Mm.
He's kind of a smaller guy compared to some of the other wrestlers out there. So it's, and that's kind of the classic thing that the WWE tends to gravitate towards, is big dudes.
Right.
Big, beefy, hulking dudes. And they don't always know what to do with the smaller guys that are just, like, super badasses. Which is weird, because in the UFC, like, those smaller guys, like, the light heavyweight division is... For my money, that's where the real action is. Yeah, it's the good split between endurance and strength, you know. Whereas the heavyweights punch each other out, you know, they just get tired.
Right.
They're just huge.
I just went and typed AJ into Google, and Styles was the first match. So
yeah, sure.
I guess that dude's pretty popular.
Yeah, so it sounds like he may be coming in. It's all rumor, it's all, you know, stuff that sounds like it's happening.
Is that like a huge deal, like worlds colliding kind of thing?
No, because like TNA never mattered in a grand sense. So it's like, it's in their eyes, they're gonna say, he wrestled on the Independence for a decade. He's one of the best in the world that hasn't wrestled here. And they will never acknowledge where he wrestled before.
Oh, wow. They're just that shitty and anti-competitive.
With them specifically, like they'll mention like New Japan Pro Wrestling, which is where these guys were wrestling up until recently. They'll even mention WCW because they bought them.
Right.
TNA is the one exception.
Is that because TNA is the closest thing to a credible threat?
Sure. Yeah. Basically.
Even if they're not actually credible, they're
Yes.
Closest thing to it.
Yeah, it's, you know, mentioning them just does them a favor.
It legitimizes
them in
some way.
By reminding people that they exist.
Right?
Yeah, it does legitimize them, yeah. So so they're careful not to do that, which I think is probably the right move, even if it is sort of shitty. This guy's got a mullet.
Yeah.
So
and like, a dumb middle part bangs thing.
Yeah. Why wouldn't you? You know, I got some assists. I got some points there. Captured some stuff. In the armory here, I got some more GP for leveling up to level 3. And so it goes.
Seems like a perfectly serviceable free-to-play first-person shooter.
It's not bad. I think there are better options out there. It was like you know, Blacklight Retribution is a free-to-play shooter that I've seen people say, like, hey, play that instead of this. But I haven't played that in a very long time, so I couldn't tell you one way or the other. It's just very thin. It's in early access, so, you know, kind of see where it goes. But just, like, the core of it is just a very standard first-person shooter.
Yeah, that's kind of a bummer.
And taken against the license and what the license is capable of, or the type of game you could make set in this, you know, cyberspace world and all this other stuff. Like, the idea of coming out with a shooter that bears a lot of resemblance to a game like Call of Duty just seems almost insulting. If one were a major fan of this property,
yeah, absolutely.
I feel like you would come away from this going like, you have hit zero marks.
Coming at it from that angle.
You have checked zero boxes on things I would want in a Ghost in the Shell game.
That's unfortunate.
Even with my limited knowledge of Ghost in the Shell, I come away from this going like, this is not at all evocative of what I know as Ghost in the Shell.
It's not like there are a lot of other games based on the property these days, either.
Yeah, I mean, they're kind of so, never. I mean, there have been a handful over the years.
There was
that PS1 game that was like basically you were in the tank, I think.
Yes.
For most of that, right?
I remember that.
And there was the PSP game. I think there's maybe one PS2 game that didn't come out over here. I don't remember. I can't speak to the quality of any of those either. But this just seems strange.
Yeah.
I wanted to show this to people because it's so weird.
It seems a little underwhelming for what it could have been.
Yeah, so I don't know, you know, maybe they, you know, they need feedback.
Yeah.
Maybe if you were to join their forums and say, what?
Just go to their forums and type more anime.
Don't do that. Maybe if you were into it, maybe some constructive criticism. I don't know, but it seems like they're so far along with like what this thing is. I just don't know. I don't know what this thing. I don't know that this thing needs to happen.
Have they said when it's going to be done?
We could check the store page. The early access form always has that, like.
Oh, projected.
You know, projected release date type stuff. View community. Is that how we get here?
Yeah, and then
store page.
Yes.
Yeah, so you can get in for $5. You know, which is a. And hey, the reviews are mostly positive, which is a weird.
And they got a decent number of reviews.
Which is weird. Brings to life. Yeah, I don't know about that.
Sometime in 2016.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we're in it now.
How will the full version differ? Additional characters, additional modes, additional maps, more weapons, more skins, bug fixes, balance passes, and improvements. That doesn't necessarily move me.
Yeah.
Like if this is the core of it and that's where they're going, like I just don't.
Yeah, a shooter. It will remain.
Well, yeah. I there are so many other shooters out there. I just, I don't get it, man.
Yeah.
That's weird.
I can't help you. I don't know.
Yeah. Anyway.
It's odd. At least now we know.
Yeah. Also, one more thing. AJ Styles has grown kind of a beard and wears a hoodie. And
yeah.
He kind of looks like a Tekken character
I didn't think of that, but now that you say that, that's exactly what these pictures look
like.
Yes.
He's updated his look for the Japanese market to kind of look like a Tekken character, which I think is...
That's
a better look than he had when he was wrestling on the TV in the US.
That's pretty smart. Like, so, Tekken character really sums it up.
Yeah. So I don't know. Maybe they'll do something cool with that will make me want to watch wrestling again. But instead, I'm just kind of sitting here, reading up on it here and there, and going like, I don't know, man. I don't know.
Don't do it, man. Don't get your hopes up.
No, that's the key.
That's the worst thing.
Do not get your hopes up about wrestling because it only exists to get you excited for 2 weeks and then the bottom drops out yet again and you go, oh man, what could have been?
It's the eternal roller coaster.
Thanks, Brad.
Yep.